Willie's memories take him back to the little town of Abbott, Texas, where he was born and lived the first 20 years of his life, and where today Willie is very much the talk of the town.
Of course, it's been only recently that people have realized that Abbott, Texas is Willie's hometown, and this has attracted people because they've come into town, they want to get close to Willie's roots, they want to see where Willie lived as a kid, where he grew up. They want to get close to people that he knew because I think that they really enjoy Willie and they identify with Willie and they want to feel the closeness of the hometown by coming here and they feel a more close to Willie, I think, by coming here and visiting in Abbott.
I went to school with him all of my years in school, but on a rainy day, like even in the fourth and fifth grade, here came Willie with his guitar slung over his back. Because he knew we couldn't play outside, so he brought his guitar, and we sang the old songs.
He, of course, was a great athlete in basketball especially, and baseball, and also football.
What I remember of him in school, he was just a plain red, white, and blue-blooded American boy.
When we were in the eighth grade at the high school, that was two-story, and the eighth grade was in one of the upper story classrooms, and teacher had to go down to the office for some reason, and we dared him to let us hang him out the window by his heels, and he said we could, so we did. We hung him out the window upside down for about 15 minutes until the teacher got back and called us, and then we all got in trouble over that.
Willie was in the first grade. He was just a little bitty kid while he and his grandmother, she worked in the lunchroom. And one day he went out there to ask her for a nickel. And she said, well, I don't have a nickel. And old Willie said, well, he said, someday I'm going to take this old guitar and make you $1,000,000. So I guess that's the same old guitar that he's playing today.
Well, I met Willie when he was 13. He was playing in the band with Bud Fletcher and the Texans, which was his brother-in-law. They started playing here at the Night Owl. He was just a wild, red-headed, freckle-faced kid that you'd never think that would get anywhere because his voice was changing. It'd start out in one key and it would raise to a higher key or a lower key. You just never thought that he'd get anywhere. He's sincere in his singing. The songs, they come from within his heart. The ones that he writes, sings from other people, he's just down to earth.